Have a look at this. It's a bit of the human body. These are cells from the inside of a human cheek, magnified thousands of times. They're similar to the kinds of cells all complex plants and animals are built from. Now, here's another one of these human cells on its own. See those tiny black marks? They are bacteria. You can see they're thousands of times smaller than my cells, and they're much simpler too.
The puzzle is this. For the first billion years or so, life on Earth consisted entirely of simple, single cells like bacteria and archaea. And then suddenly, around 2 billion years ago, complex cells appeared, cells more like the ones that make up you and me. And it seems they appeared out of the blue.
So did life really leap from simple cells to complexity in one fell swoop? After all, we normally think of evolution proceeding in tiny, incremental steps.
There's a strange dichotomy within the theory of evolution. There are lots of them. They're a quarrelsome lot. Between what sometimes called evolution by jerks versus evolution by creeps, OK? I was always a bit of a creep in my time, which was that actually evolution is a bit like a clock. It ticks slowly around and goes, it speeds up and slows down a bit. The jerks line was that evolution went slowly most of the time, and then whoopee, there was a wonderful moment when it took a dizzying leap into the void and leapt over to a new form of life. But actually, I hate to say it, it causes me great pain to say this. There are some cases where it's clear that a dizzying leap was made in evolution.
And the reason we now accept that this, and indeed other dizzying leaps, can happen is because of what we've learned from studying DNA. From our and other species' genetic code. This is Dr. Nick Lane. He studies this puzzling transformation when life went from being simple to complex. It all started with the curious marriage of two simple cells.
2 billion years ago, or give or take, literally a billion years, this first complex cell arose, and it seems to have come about by one cell getting inside another cell, really as simple as that.
The host cell was probably an archaea, and the cell that got inside it was a bacterium.
So an archaea, like the ones in the hot springs in Iceland, swallowed a cell of that other type of microbial life that was around 2 billion years ago, bacteria.
So what did that mean for evolution?
But what happened as a result of that is complex life evolved. Very soon after that event, plants, or at least algae, green algae leading to plants, fungi, mushrooms and so on, animals, all diverged quite quickly, very, very early on, quite soon after this cell got within a cell.
But why did this moment of one cell consuming another kickstart complex life? The answer boils down to one word: energy. The bacteria that got swallowed evolved into a kind of power station that fueled the whole cell. They're called mitochondria. The host now had the means to get bigger and bigger and maintain bigger genomes. Suddenly, cells like the ones we are made of became a possibility.
I think that was the critical moment in all of evolution, as we see it, because if we're interested in intelligent beings or life as we know it, then it's really that event is the very beginning of it all.